June 4, 2022. 100 days of war. 100 days of death, destruction, bloodshed and loss. Tens of thousands have lost their lives. Many were civilians. More than 12 million men, women and children forced from their homes.
They're defending an almost deserted city.
We're underground at the moment in a basement where a lot of school children hid from the artillery.
Ukraine's historical and cultural sites devastated by fighting. In Russia, major Western companies like McDonald's, Starbucks and Nike have fled in defiance, many replaced by cheap Russian imitations. Experts say these high-profile departures, along with continuing international sanctions, are crippling the Russian economy. However, there are debates about Russia's economic resilience and whether sanctions are actually the right approach, with some saying they affect ordinary Russians who have nothing to do with the war and could play into Putin's anti-Western rhetoric. By June 15, Zelensky pleads for more and faster deliveries of Western arms and weapons, which were crucial to defend Ukraine's east. NATO heard his call. But the arrival of arms would not be instant. Days after that announcement on June 25th, Ukrainian troops pull out of Severodonetsk, a strategic industrial city, one of Ukraine's last strongholds in the Luhansk region, and one which Putin was desperate to win. And he did that by unleashing hell on the city. Russians outnumbered Ukrainian forces by 10 to 1.